And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jilly loves you more than you will know.
Hey, it's Lucy Robinson here!
Hey, it's Lucy Robinson here!
So, after the huge success of the first season of Lucy Robinson, which was about me being in Chile, you can check the links below, it's time for season 2. Each episode is gonna be in a different place with some practical information how to get around somewhere. So today is gonna be my must-do before traveling, or something that is really worth using during the travels, especially when you have little time to prepare and you don't want to spend the fortune. The first thing I do, I download the app called Triposo. It's really cool because you have an offline map, you have the restaurants, bars and top attractions you should go to see, and you can actually track the where you are and how long you should go there, what's your directions. It's pretty cool because you can check the restaurants nearby, the bars nearby and top attractions you should go for, and you have also a description of this place, for example, what's the pricing, and actually you can check what's the way there. Second thing, what is also important to go around the city, I download the maps.me or maps.me. It's really cool because you can see the name of the street. Triposo does not have all the names of the street though. The third thing I always check before going somewhere, if there's a free walking tour. And usually if it's a capital city, there is a free walking tour. It's a cool thing to get to know the people and the city at the same time, especially when you're traveling alone. Theoretically, it's for free, but you know, you want to give the guys a tip for their awesome job, because I haven't been on a free walking tour that sucked. Everything was really, really cool and the guides were amazing, with funny stories, with engaging stories, and with a lot of people who are actually really listening. Fourth thing I check is a pub crawl. It's a pub crawl and the name of the city, like pub crawl Warsaw, pub crawl New Delhi, or pub crawl Praha. Well, it's not for free, and I think the price depends on the city, but I think it's around $10 to $15 for the whole night. And it's a really cool concept because, again, you meet a lot of people, either locals or really interesting people who are traveling as well. And the fifth thing is couch surfing, for spending a day with a local person or getting a bed for free there. I mean, usually at a short notice, it's not always possible to get a free sleeping place. But you can, of course, ask them to just, they can show you around, and from the local perspective, you see all the places in the world. So it's always better to use the knowledge of a local person, not to follow always the Lonely Planet guide, where you can meet 100 of German tourists in one spot because it was said to be at this place at 6 p.m. at this day, and that's where all they are there. Pam pam pam. In order to have friends at the place you're going, some people are using Tinder Pro so they can swipe in a place that they're going. Personally, I don't use that. It's completely fine. I mean, fine, you can use it, right? There is an option. It's an option. If somebody likes that, I'm fine. I heard a lot of stories. I don't want to share that. But some people are using it. And last but not least, I also Google and check the trip advisor, must see, must do in a place where I'm going. That's it from my side. If you have your must do list, maybe you can share it in a comment, or yeah, why not? You can just write it in a comment, what do you do before traveling, or how do you get prepared for seeing another place. Hope you find it useful and see you guys. Bye!